Hello, hello, PTSD Self-Healing Show. And we are with Jennifer Aks-Neuman. Very excited and very happy to have her because you don't know what are we going to talk. Today we're going to talk about dancing. And dancing has a great power, even power of healing. As you know, art therapy is one of the best healing power for PTSD and people with depression. And these days in isolation, we don't want to be depressed. We want to thrive, we want to be happy, and we want to express our emotion. Let's introduce Jennifer to our show. Welcome to our show, Jennifer. Thank you so much for being here. All right, we have some introduction about her. Let's just go and watch what she's doing.
I started Dance herStory during this pandemic. I now help women tell their stories with movement. It's like a diary entry, but instead with movement. So instead of writing, we're moving, and through video recordings, we're capturing so that they can look back on this forever. The transformative power of this is incredibly profound. No matter what your life story, if it's filled with transition, celebration, creating a movement story gives women an opportunity to create art out of their life.
Wow, you are doing an amazing job. I'm really amazed. And the first time actually she reached to me, I said, I'm going to show her in this show. Because the way they are expressing themselves is amazing. You can actually, during this COVID, everybody trying to find a way to be happy and thrive. So tell me about yourself. How did you start it and what is your background? What was the first idea in your mind that you said, oh, I'm going to do this?
Yeah. Well, thank you. Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it. I'm very excited to be here. I did not wake up one morning and say, I need to come up with something. What do I want to do? This happened so naturally. This just happened so organically because literally Dance herStory is everything that I love, everything that I've done. It's all of the elements have been in my careers up until this point. I was a photographer, an editor. I've been teaching inner city children for the last 13 years, empowering. I work for an organization and we empower the children through the arts. Help lift up their voices and encourage them and help them be the best version of themselves, right? So I love doing this in all ways, working with adults and working with children. So those elements have always been there. I've written and directed shows and I've been a dancer my whole life. So dance was my entry into movement. It was always been my comfort, my way of communicating with the world. So when the pandemic hit, I was just kind of like everybody else saying to myself, I feel isolated. There's boundaries around us all. How can I reconnect to the communities that I love, remain creative and collaborative? So I literally was just like, I'm going to throw it all in. It's like taking all the ingredients from your refrigerator and just, you know, what do they say? Throw in everything from the kitchen sink, you know, whatever the term is. And so I just put it all together and I asked 8 other women that I have worked with if they would create a movement story with me. And they were kind of like, sure. And what is that? So I said, you know, I want to tell your story. I want you to tell me how you feel during this pandemic. How is this emotion living in your body? What is the emotion that's living in your body? And let's use our movement to express this story. They were all ready to go. And so we met on Zoom a couple of times, which was beautiful because it allowed for community, which solved one of the you know, issues that people were having, right? I checked that box. It was like, this can create community and vulnerability and expression. So we talked about it. I shared with them sort of more of the vision. They recorded their expression of how they're feeling in this moment with their movement. They sent it to me. I edited it together. We watched it. We cried. It was beautiful. And so I knew at that moment that I was onto something and that I wanted to offer this to women. And I'll just say one other thing. I mean, there's lots of things to say. I want to talk with you. But the other thing is that what I've been really learning through this journey is that it's not dance. Dance is my entry into movement. That's my, but it's a metaphor for how you move through your life. So I'm doing a movement story now with a painter. She's taking her paintbrush and she's painting, and we're getting clips of her art and the colors and the canvases and how she moves through this experience to tell her story. I'm doing that with writers and painters and yogis and people that just like walking through their parks, you know? So it's all about what movement speaks to you, what movement is authentic to you, and how can we use that to tell your story?
It's beautiful the way they express themselves. I feel there are lots of emotion inside. Because especially during the pandemic, when you have your mask on it, you're isolated sometimes, you go to depression and you cannot express yourself.
Yes.
You don't know what to say, what to do. And then you go to silence. There is no creativity. There is depression there. Mm-hmm. And the way you challenge them is that you ask them, encourage them to create something.
Mm-hmm.
And creation activates pineal gland, mm-hmm. which is everything.
Mm-hmm.
Like it can actually balance your hormones, and it can make you happy again, you know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And the way you can actually do other movement, but this dancing is kind of beautiful expression of emotion that I love. So did you study dance?
Yes, I've danced my whole life. I have been dancing since I was, you know, like three. And dance has always been my language and where I'm comfortable. You know, I was just talking about this earlier with a friend, how the, you know, academics were fine for me. But writing and all of it, it was good, but it wasn't like where I found my comfort was moving my expression, moving my language, and communicating like that. I love being in conversation with movement. And you can have conversation. You know, there are many times I'm just thinking, I remember visiting a friend of mine who lives in Paris and she has two children. This was a long time ago. And none of her family spoke English. But I went and we connected. And we fell in love with each other, just loved each other when I left, but we didn't utter one word. I didn't understand what they were saying. They didn't understand what I was saying. I learned then that I was like 15 years old when that happened, actually. She had children very young. And it taught me that you don't need words. You don't need words to share, to connect, to communicate, you know? So yeah, so dance has always been sort of my entry. And now I'm inviting people to dance their life, dance their story, but in their way, you know, not necessarily dancing. We're not turning and it's not choreography. It's not, you know, doing leaps across the stage. It's really taking authentic day-to-day movement and using that to help you feel comfortable within your story.
You know, you said something interesting. The thing which connects people together is heart, is not language, because English is not my first language. But right now, I don't feel this barrier. Right now, I can understand people everywhere.
Right.
Because we all have the same emotion. We have the same body language.
Mm-hmm.
We become sad, happy. So there is like we are all human. And this pandemic shows us that even in this virtual life, there is a life.
Mm-hmm.
There mm-hmm. is a connection between people, and we can actually share emotion, be together, and create a beautiful connection mm-hmm. among us.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yes. So what is your vision of having this dance herStory? What do you want to do with this? Where do you want to go with this?
I love that question. Well, because it was born during this pandemic, I've only been doing this for 5 months, even though I feel like I've been doing it my whole life, because it's everything that I love all in one. And I've also now done 30 stories, 30 movement stories in 5 months. I mean, it's unbelievable, but I just love it. You know, I want to be here. I want to support. So where do I see it going? I want to keep telling these stories. I want women to share their stories, but also I want people to not only feel like they do this to share and empower others, it's also a very personal and private experience. So I want to use this to help heal and empower and inspire, both personally and privately, and people can use it for all kinds of other more public things, but it's a range. So on the individual level, I want to keep creating these stories and share as many as possible to help inspire others. I want to continue to do groups. This is exciting. I've been doing several groups, whether it's retreats or workshops that I've put together, or I've done a story where we were all kind of sharing the vision of how do we feel in this pandemic? So there's many ways to bring the groups together. But the group has so much power, because the more and more I do with them, because we are telling our stories in a workshop together, not using our words, but our bodies. And I can explain the process if you want me to do that. But we share in an experience that doesn't require words. And the community I'm finding from the feedback that I'm getting is that it's incredibly powerful for so many reasons. People feel a lot of comfort. People feel seen and heard in a totally different way. We share sort of our gestures and our expression together, and it resonates in all kinds of ways. So I want to continue with the group work. I want to work with retreats. I want to offer this for, you know, women's retreats and different organizations focused on girls and women. I would love to have an art gallery someday, you know, displaying these stories. And in fact, I'm doing a virtual art gallery next weekend. So you should come I said, you know, why am I going to wait until the pandemic is over when we can all go to galleries and museums again? I'm going to create a virtual one. So I did. And so I want to, you know, celebrate these women on whatever platform, in whatever way that I can. So those are just a few ideas. You know, who knows, maybe there's a documentary down the road. Who knows?
You know, I'm going to refer to 2 points.
Yes.
First of all, I love group healing.
Mm-hmm.
I have the same experience.
Yes.
Because I couldn't talk about the PTSD for myself when I was hit by a car, you know, blah, blah, blah. I had an accident. And then in a group, we all talk, and the leader of the group said, you have to express yourself, yell it. You shouldn't hide it inside. And that's
right.
You could connect with others, and you see that other people have the same experience.
Mm-hmm.
And this is beautiful. Everybody share their stories after sometimes you help each other to heal. Help each other heal and recover from PTSD or depression, whatever.
Yes, yes.
And it's not only through talking, as you said.
Right.
That's a beautiful way when you can dance. I love dancing as well. Sometimes when I was a child, I just tried to dance in a mirror, you know, when I didn't feel good. And then I feel, oh, wow, I feel great. So that's the way. But what is the process? As you said, you're going to talk about the process. Tell me about it. You should learn.
Okay, great. Thank you. I'm really happy to share this with you because you were just saying so beautifully, like that healing power of sharing our stories through movement. So I'm excited to share the process with you. So on an individual basis, I would meet a woman on Zoom and we would start simply in conversation. You know, what is your story? What is it that you want to talk about? What do you want to express? What do you want this story to represent and do for your life? You know, we kind of go into. So I listen to the story once their story is told. Now, it not always is the breadth and entirety of someone's life. It could be a moment or a transition, the story of a divorce, the story of a celebration, the story of, I did a movement story of a mother who's leaving a message for her daughter. There's like a million versions of what your story could be. It's your, right? Everyone's got their own unique voice and journey. So I'll listen to the story. And as I'm listening, I break down, I kind of like, I know where I'm going creatively. So I kind of create the chapters of the story as I see it. So I'll reflect that back and say, here are the chapters that I'm hearing. Let's figure it out together and refine it. The reason the chapters are important is because it's the chapters that become the video clips that I then get to and then edit together. So we'll define the story, the chapters, and then once the chapters are defined, we look at each one and she'll determine what the main emotion is in that chapter. So chapter one, for example, could be hurt. Chapter two might be anger. Chapter three might be validation. So then we'll talk about, well, what does hurt look like in your life? Now, this is a great way to enter the embodiment of your story without being a dancer. We're together on Zoom. So we create together, or she does, what a gesture that represents hurt. So let's just say hurt is, you know, this. Okay, so that's her gesture. And the second one is anger and it's this. And the third one is validation. So maybe it's like a more open. So we'll create sort of a gesture sequence that helps the start of the embodiment of her story. We'll put on some music, she'll do it. It's very emotional and extremely beautiful and a way in to movement, moving your story. So once that all is defined, it seems to just, the process seems to really work beautifully. And when that's done, she will then go and record video clips of those chapters. So for example, chapter one was filled with anger. Well, where is she gonna film anger? She might be in her bed, like throwing pillows, or in the closet, punching, what does anger look like? What environment would represent and help tell that chapter of your life? So then the second one was, you know, was anger, hurt. And then the third one is validation. Well, maybe she's running through the park or swinging on a swing set in a playground. I mean, I don't know, what is it? So she will record herself with those chapters, send them to me. I do the editing. And then we'll meet again on Zoom and I'll show her where I'm at in the editing process. And that's when she tells me, gives me feedback. You know, this feels good. This doesn't feel good. I want to add, I want to subtract. We refine it together. That's about 30 minutes. It's not long at all. And the first one's only about an hour. So it's not a very long time commitment on our calls. And then the third session is when I show her the video story, the final one, and we reflect and talk about the experience. So that's the journey, but I just want to say that in a group environment, we do this, we do a similar thing. We journal without sharing words about whatever it is I prompt. Once the journaling is done, each woman in the group will create a gesture that represents whatever they just journaled about. And they don't need to tell us what it is. So they'll create a gesture. And we learn each other's gesture. So all of a sudden we're all sharing each other's gesture. So it becomes like this movement phrase, this movement gesture phrase. And it's really beautiful. And we'll do a few of those. And it's so powerful. And then if the group wants, I will create a video movement story from that Zoom call. I'll edit it and create a video from it. Does that make sense? It's a lot.
I love it. You know, this is a combination of journaling and then expressing yourself, which I always use in my PTSD self-healing groups or with my clients.
Yep.
Because the first thing, they need a safe place to express themselves.
Exactly.
And they share in a group and they do journaling and they see that there is a creative way, which is not boring, is not only talking about this. You don't need to cry or whatever.
Right.
You just try, you have to first discover your emotion, which sometimes we don't.
Right.
Sometimes we hide it. We even don't know what is these chapters. Then you help them to discover these chapters. And at the end, probably there is a good outcome, right? There is a good chapter at the end, empowering or healing. Somebody feel that healed already. Is there any chapter there that they still stuck? They feel stuck and is not healed yet? And
100%.
It continues. Maybe next time.
Yes, exactly. And I think that's a beautiful and very honest way to go about this. You know, the journey never ends. It's never really over. Our story continues forever. So it doesn't have to be a story and we're done. It's an evolution. You know, one of the movement stories that I did recently with a group, the third prompt was, where do you want to see, where are you going? Like, what do you want to see in the next stage of your life? These are all women that were over 50, right? And it was like, what is your next thing? What emotion do you want to see living? And like, let's embody that so we can feel it. So we did that. But to your point, they're not there yet. They're just envisioning, what is the hope and the dream? What do I want to, what energy do I want to bring in so that I see more of it? So we do that. And yeah, they're not always done. And I think that's part of it. And that's so okay and very, very honest. So yes, I've experienced that a lot.
But they create their vision, and is not only by thinking, because they give more powers to this vision.
Right.
When I work with my clients, I try to use all senses.
Mm-hmm.
Because you can have a dream back of your mind, but it never come to reality because you never use your five senses.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, what they do with your program, oh my goodness, they do writing, they think about it, and they from the current situation, and then they create their vision.
Exactly.
They already activate their brain to create it, and they give a lot of energy to empower to this dream.
Right.
Dream is only first is just the thinking, and then you create the vision, and then you give lots of powers to this vision. And I never thought about it like a movement. I love that. Like, when you add movement, you already one step ahead, because you are acting upon it.
Exactly.
Exactly. Action is so powerful.
Yep.
So even if you haven't achieved it, but because you pretend that you achieved it already, so you are one step ahead.
Exactly. I completely agree. You know, it's the mind plays such a large role, as you know, the psychology of how we get to where we want to go. We have to tell sometimes we just have to tell ourselves, I'm gonna get there, or I'm gonna be happy, or I'm going to, you know, we have to help ourselves. And so yes, believing and creating the vision and then acting on it, it can only help make it a reality.
You know, you are creator of your dreams. We are creator of your dreams. And this is a unique way. Your dreams come to reality by power of dancing. Mm-hmm. That's what you can name it. Dance herStory. And, you know, that was one of the beautiful interviews I had. From the beginning, I had a smile on my face because I really enjoy that. I love dancing. And this is, I never thought about self-healing and this power and creating or vision by dancing. And that gave me a lot of knowledge and how we can create it.
Absolutely. And again, you know, and I always go back to this. I feel like people get caught up on the word dance and say, I'm not a dancer. I can't do this. I'm not. It's not that. Dance is my thing. But yours could be, you obviously like dancing, but I'm saying you, someone else, it could be writing. You know, I'll say, you don't need to dance. What do? How do you move? What's your relationship to movement? How do you move through your life? And then they'll say, oh, well, I, you know, do Pilates. Oh, great. Let's use Pilates. How are we going to use Pilates to help tell your story? You know, I cook, I paint, I draw, I, you know, I'm an artist, I sculpture. I mean, how beautiful, how graceful. It's all fluid. Movement is fluid. So we can use that to help us communicate our stories.
You know, I was talking to my client today. It's interesting. Yeah. One of my fertility clients, and she also loved dancing. I said, I'm going to tag you on this. And dancing, I said, you are creating your expression with dancing, mm-hmm. with movement. And art therapy is the best for any disease or mm-hmm. any depression. Yes. So, Jennifer, tell me about, I know you have a website, Dance Her Story, how people can reach you.
Oh.
How does it start?
Yes. So, I have, my website is www.dancerstory.com. I see it at the bottom of your screen rolling, which is great. Thank you. I'm on Instagram at dance_herstory and Facebook, same thing, Dance Her Story. And yeah, and what a great, this is great timing because I am doing a virtual art gallery where I'm highlighting three women and their movement stories, their movement diaries. And it'll give people, it's a free event. It's next Saturday at 8:00 Eastern Standard Time. And it will give people a good idea of what this is all about. But more than that, just bringing people together to, you know, bring a drink of choice, socialize, feel connected in community. So yeah, they can come to that event. They can find me on my website or my Instagram or Facebook.
Your event is like a virtual event or
a virtual gallery?
Oh,
yes,
a gallery one. Okay, that's what you sent to me.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've created three virtual gallery rooms. Beautiful. And everyone's going to go to the gallery rooms and come back to the main gallery and go back out and come back. It'll be really nice.
Yeah, I love to bring more artists to this program because I always feel that art gives you a lot of inspiration, especially during this isolation time.
Yes.
Isolation and pandemic has lots of benefits, to be honest.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Time you find yourself, you express yep. yourself, you talk with your emotion, and you deeply create your vision. That's what we did. That's what you did, actually. And
thank you.
I'm going to actually use some of these methods with my own client.
Yes.
This is beautiful. Like,
thank you.
Especially for women. I love women because they have a lot of ways to express themselves, and they don't need to be silent in this right. situation, even if they feel depressed. Create your vision, create your vision with dancing, with
exactly.
movement, and
with
then
movement.
You are one step ahead.
Exactly, absolutely. Beautiful. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
I was just going to say something you said just inspired this thought. I talked to a woman recently that I'm working with, and she said, this is going to help me reclaim my voice because I feel like my voice was taken from me. She had a
wow.
difficult
wow.
journey. And And she is. She's finding her voice through this process. And that's, you know, it's just beautiful.
Creation help you to focus on your mind and your think. Need distraction. When we are depressed, we don't need to go take alcohol or other medications. There are other ways you can create your ways. And that's what you suggest as well. And because, as you said, we can express ourselves with movement. Thank you so much. Do you have your last word?
For dance your life. Dance your story. You know, just do it in whatever way that feels right.
Create your diary and feel happy, especially in this isolation. This is the best time to create your vision with dancing.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Yes.